Lucid had invited me to preview the pre-production Gravity back in December 2024. Since then, it's been a curious wait. For months, access was pretty limited, with just a handful of folks getting a crack at the production version earlier this year during a very controlled drive event. And even now in July, it's just starting to reach a broader audience, but still in a careful rollout. Test drives, for instance, are mostly restricted to early reservation holders. One update that really stood out is the arrival of a native NACS port. Finally, Lucid actually follows Hyundai here, interestingly enough, but I expect that to change fast. Most of the major automakers have signed on to Tesla's charging standard, and from what I understand, there's a mandate in place to offer native NACS by 2027. Still waiting on full confirmation of that though. So when Lucid reached out inviting me to check out the production version, it came as a bit of a surprise. The timing wasn't something I expected, but I'll tag along. One ongoing concern with Lucid has been the software. Even with the Air, it was hard to find a version completely free of small bugs. Features like route planning always felt like they were coming soon. Now for me, route planning is one of the top three essentials in any EV. The other two being battery preconditioning and plug-in charge. Together, these three are the real test of how solid the software and the system integration are. So let's start with the software. Not that I expect this to be fully ready and available to the full extent. The climate control has separate buttons for each seat's temperature and fan, plus ventilated seats, heated steering, and all the usual features. Alongside the main climate control are what looks like settings for the front seat massage with the related memory and storage functions. That follows the energy consumption chart displaying the energy use of various applications, driving lights, infotainment, etc. On top is the charging info and it shows the manual battery preconditioning button. That follows the range button which calculates and displays on a map the places around that you can reach based on various variables like terrain, weather, road conditions, etc. Then you have the usage screen again and an interesting graphic showing the consumption of the various power outlets. That should be useful when camping and on road trips. That follows the navigation menu and on the right you see the voice prompt button, map modes like north up, route overview, 3D, 2D, etc. The charging options and the button for the general navigation settings. In the settings on top, you have the default or the satellite map options. You also have an offline mode, a rain spider that again displays the places the car can reach with its current battery and conditions, and also a toggle to add charging stops. That follows the built-in infotainment where I see options to save your tracks and a search button. This is where Apple CarPlay will probably end up as well. Or maybe it will have its own separate button. That will remain to be seen. Next to that is the phone app and the 360 camera view. That's where feeds from multiple high-resolution cameras are stitched together to create a really useful utility. It's truly useful in tight parking spots and other tight spaces. That's yet another wonder of a software-defined electric vehicle. Next is the Sanctuary, Gravity's feature to turn the cabin into a wellness spa. That's where multi-sensory media, integrating lighting, audio, video, seat massage and such features, create these thematic experiences. That follows the button to access all of the vehicle settings. On top is the vehicle menu with the trip information with trip A and B and the trip data since the last charge. Then the driving dynamics with the stability control settings for partial and full, and the one pedal modes for hold and creep. I can imagine hold being pretty much an industry standard now. I also see what looks like pin to drive and tilting mirrors on reverse. That follows the ADAS settings for Lucid's Dream Drive, that standard adaptive cruise control and lane assistance, with settings for the cruising speed with the typical offsets, and even a control for speed on curves, I would guess. That also goes with safety and parking settings. That follows the connectivity settings, the general settings, and a menu to access the installed apps, all with the standard language, units, time zone, etc. That's followed by the software menu for OTA updates, an important place in a modern EV. At the end is the general user manual. The Tahoe theme is Lucid's top tier leather option. They are using real Napa full grain and natural grain leather here, not synthetics or vegan alternatives. It comes in this beautiful two-tone combination, Lucid black and a warm saddle brown. You'll find it across the front and second row seats, including the bolsters, headrests, and center armrests. There's a walnut burl wood trim running through the dash, doors and center console. This I think isn't the fake stuff, it's real wood, with visible grain and texture that gives the whole interior a very grounded natural feel. For the headliner pillars and some portions of the door panels and center console, they are gone with eco suede. It's synthetic but very soft and rich to the touch, gives the cabin a calm, upscale character while staying eco-conscious. You'll also spot brushed metal in the knobs, HVAC vents and surrounding some buttons. These details help bring a sense of craftsmanship and contrast to the softer materials. And underneath it all, Lucid is using high-grade soft-touch plastics to shape the interior. If you're checking out a Tahoe trim Gravity in person, a few things to look for. Run your hand over the seats. Napa leather has this warm, varied texture unlike the smooth and flat feel of synthetics. The leather is perforated in a cross-hatch pattern which is unique to Tahoe and Ojai interiors. The walnut trim has depth and natural variation you won't see in plastic, and the metal elements feel cool and solid, not hollow or painted plastic. The interior should really hold up and the cabin should look close to new for long. That said, it's real leather, so you'll want to keep it conditioned and clean with products made specifically for Napa hides. Visually, the Tahoe interior is probably the most luxurious setup in the Gravity lineup. The contrast between the black and saddle tones, the warmth of the wood, the softness of the suede, and the solid feel of the metal accents, it all adds up to something that feels both premium and inviting. The steering is a circle, much like the Cybertruck, though with a completely different feel here. A shape that blends square and circle. You still get the comfort and muscle memory of a traditional wheel, but the slightly flattened top gives you a totally clear view of that 34-inch curved OLED screen behind it. It avoids the yoke-style distractions, keeping it functional and ergonomic. On either side of the wheel are touch-sensitive pads where your thumbs rest. Lucid calls them micro-tablets. You should be able to swipe or tap to adjust media, climate, and certain driver assist features. They give haptic feedback so you know they have registered, which helps keep your focus on the road. I find it slightly small in size though. The stocks are straightforward. The left one handles turn signals and also doubles up when Dream Drive Pro is active. Just a tap and the car will initiate a lane change for you. Look for the pricing on driver assistance though, it could be an add-on. The others cover the usual functions like wipers and headlights. Just ahead of the steering wheel is the driver monitoring system. It uses an infrared camera to watch where you're looking. If your attention drifts or you're not watching the road, it'll alert you. Ignore those alerts and it starts pulling back on driver assist features for safety. Even in hands-free mode, the system expects a light grip on the wheel. It's not full autonomy, but it's close enough for longer, more relaxed highway stretches. The Gravity's cabin experience strikes a really good balance. The circle wheel gives you clear visibility of the display. The touchpads are modern but not frustrating. The stocks are intuitive and the monitoring system is just quietly there doing its job. Standard air suspension gives you 7 inches of ground clearance and it rides really well even without any height adjustments. But if you go for the $2,900 dynamic handling package, that's where the magic happens. You get a more advanced 3-chamber air system that lets you adjust from 5 inches for better aerodynamics on the highway, all the way up to 9 inches for snow or light off-roading. And it auto-adjusts based on speed and drive mode, which is a nice touch. Combine that with rear-wheel steering and suddenly this big SUV feels nimble. Seriously tight parking lots, U-turns, winding roads, it handles all of that better than you'd expect. It's almost shocking how composed it feels in corners. At this price point though, I'd argue that kind of agility should be expected, not just a pleasant surprise. Inside, the 34-inch curved 6K screen is a showpiece. It looks amazing and more importantly, it's responsive. The 12.6-inch center display is also snappy and well organized. Apple CarPlay is wireless, but weirdly still no Android Auto. That's a miss in 2025 and I really hope they address that in an OTA update. I would still argue for a better integrated native system in a car like Lucid. There are USB-C ports all over. 100 watt up front, 45 watt in the back, and 120 volt household outlets in all three rows. If you spring for the $600 power package, you also get outlets in the frunk and second row, which is handy. Again though, a frunk drain would have taken it to the next level. If you want more tech, there's a $3,200 technology package that gives you a head-up display and ambient lighting that you can customize. It's cool, no doubt, but those packages start to add up fast. The battery setup is solid. There are two pack sizes, 16 and 22 module, and each module runs at 42 volts. Altogether, the large system hits 926 volts when fully charged, and you are looking at around 123 kilowatt hour usable capacity, maybe 126 to 127 kilowatt hour gross. Charging speeds can be crazy fast if you are at the right station. The Gravity uses the NACS connector, so you are good with Tesla superchargers right out of the box. On a V3 Tesla charger, you can expect around 220 kilowatt. But on a top tier public DC fast charger, you might hit that 400 kilowatt peak or a bit more, again if everything lines up perfectly. Lucid includes both an 80 amp AC adapter and a CCS to NACS adapter rated for 500 amps, though that may still need the certification. One really clever design choice is the rear mounted charge port. It shortens the path between the port, the rear inverter and the stator, which helps with cooling and efficiency during high speed charging. And get this, when you're charging from Tesla's older 400 volt high current chargers, the Gravity actually uses the rear motor to boost voltage internally. It's a completely different solution from the Air's Wonderbox setup, and honestly, it's kind of brilliant. The task for high voltage cars is to take Tesla's low 400 volt power and boost it to match the high 800 and 900 volts of the battery pack. In my opinion, this is the closest anyone's gotten to a truly seamless charging experience during the whole NACS transition. I expect this to be a solidly charging car, unlike anything before it. Finally, we have something that would be in the next level to even Tesla. The built-in NACS port and solid charging capability make this car a good option for long trips, something most non-Tesla EVs still struggle with. I'm glad Lucid paid attention after the Air, which was a good car, but didn't offer the same level of charging access and capability. It's hard to justify a high-end EV that isn't road trip ready. It'll be interesting to see this car out in the real world on long road trips. Until then, it's shaping up to be a very promising option. The front seats offer power adjustment, heating, ventilation and massage, which isn't common even in the most luxurious SUVs. Second row passengers get a full 39.5 inches of legroom, more than a BMW X7 or Tesla Model X. And you can opt for reclining captain's chairs if you want that lounge-like feeling. And here's the kicker. The third row has 36 inches of legroom, which means actual adults can sit back there comfortably. No knees up, elbows in situation like you get in most three-row EVs. That's truly three rows. The cabin materials are responsibly sourced too, with options like Nappa leather and Alcantara style fabrics, and the finishing touches like the contrast stitching and backlit Lucid logos make it feel premium without trying too hard. It's clear Lucid wanted every seat to matter, and they actually have managed that. Please confirm all the details and options stated here at the point of consequence. A car like this can undergo several changes when coming out. To compare it with other three-row options out there, the Lucid Gravity, the Rivian R1S and the Tesla Model X are all software-defined three-row electric SUVs with unique strengths. As a quick comparison, the Lucid Gravity offers luxury seating for up to 7 passengers, a spacious and refined interior, an estimated up to 440 miles of range, and native NACS support for seamless access to Tesla superchargers. It also delivers impressive utility with a combined cargo capacity of over 112 cubic feet, including a large frunk. The Rivian R1S seats 7 with a rugged, adventure-ready cabin, up to 104.7 cubic feet of cargo space, and DC charging up to 220 kilowatts, though it still requires an adapter for superchargers until NACS integration is complete. The Tesla Model X seats 5 to 7 passengers, offers a sleek design up to 92.3 cubic feet of cargo space and the advantage of full supercharger network integration. Each SUV excels in different areas. Luxury and range for Gravity, versatility and off-road capability for the R1S, and the ecosystem and efficiency for the Model X. My earliest impressions are available in the link here and in the description. That was with a pre-production model. The Lucid Gravity is kind of a stunner. It's fast, comfortable and packed with clever engineering. It feels like a luxury SUV most of the time, but it can flip the switch and deliver legit sports car performance when you want it. I'll surely talk about its driving at some point soon, when I can. It's not perfect. Some controls lean a bit too much into the tech for tech's sake category. The swivel steering won't be for everyone. For a six-figure vehicle, a few more features should really be standard. But for a second-ever model from a young automaker, it's incredible. There's still a lot we don't know about this car since access has been so limited and controlled. If you're curious about it, stay tuned. I'll share more as I get it. If you'd like to see some recent videos of mine, the links are available in the description. See you in the next one.